Someone recently had a good question. They had a stroke at one time, and they wanted to prevent future strokes. So they wanted to know, what would I suggest? So I wanted to do this video to talk about clots in general, what they are, what creates them, and what you can do to prevent them. So a clot or a coagulation is a group of cells that are kind of stuck together, and they can't seem to circulate through the vessels, and they get hung up in certain parts of the body. If they get hung up in your heart, you get a heart attack. If they get hung up in the brain, you get a stroke. If they get stuck in the lung, it's called a pulmonary embolism, and you can start having chest pain, breathing problems, and even cardiac arrest. If they get stuck in the deep veins of your leg, it's called a deep vein thrombosis. And that can cause pain, redness, lack of circulation, weakness. But you can get clots stuck anywhere in the body, liver and the kidney. So in the body, we have this balance of these clotting factors, especially vitamin K, and a lot of anti-clotting factors that are working together to keep the blood at the right consistency. But with a clot, we're dealing with fibrin, which is a protein. Now, there's certain things that increase your risk of developing a clot. And the big one is estrogen. Women that go through pregnancy have a higher risk of getting clots simply because of the amount of estrogen. And also the risk goes up if you're taking birth control pills or estrogen replacement therapy. Another risk factor would be obesity in general. That will double the risk. If you're a diabetic, the risk goes up. But if you're overweight, a diabetic, taking birth control pills and estrogen replacement therapy, and you're pregnant, your risk is really, really high. The real big thing that increases your risk of getting strokes is if you have insulin resistance, which is behind obesity, diabetes, prediabetes, but insulin resistance occurs long before you become a diabetic. So you could basically have insulin resistance for 10 to 15 years and not even know it if you're focused on your blood sugars. I've done a lot of videos on insulin resistance, and I will put some down below if you're new to it, but it's a very important condition to know about and prevent. If you have insulin resistance, the enzymes that break down fibrin are diminished. So you'll have decreased fibrinolysis. You just don't have the enzymes to break it down, and your risk factors go up of developing clots. And this is why people that have insulin resistance have an increased risk of getting a stroke. All right, what can you do about this? Well, number one, you can handle this right here. Be cautious of how much estrogen you're taking. Don't get pregnant so often. I'm just kidding about that. Obesity, there's a lot of things you can do about that, as well as diabetes. But there's some really powerful natural remedies that you can take to really minimize the risk factor for getting a stroke. First one is called natokinase. This is an enzyme that is made from the fermentation of soybeans, and it's a very powerful blood thinner that will help keep your blood from clotting unnecessarily. Next one. It's called lumbrokinase. What is this? Another enzyme that is extracted from earthworms. This too is a very powerful anti-clotting natural remedy with very minimal side effects. Then we have serrapeptase, which is another powerful enzyme. It helps to break down protein things that shouldn't be in your body, and it's created from a bacteria from silkworms. Bromelain is a good one as well. This is from pineapples, and this is very beneficial for the heart, and it also has been known to decrease risk of stroke. And then we have vitamin E, which is a natural blood thinner, and it does a lot of other things as well. It's a very powerful antioxidant. Before you start taking any of these, I would really have you focus on this with your diet, healthy keto, intermittent fasting, then add these right here, and then you'll be in much better shape. All right, thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.